Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Artery Gear Fusion on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Artery Gear Fusion and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Artery Gear Fusion. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, to get started we have to launch our main browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type that URL, simply because there's the clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We arrived there on our website of Usitility, at which we find here an in-depth explanation on the best way to download and install Artery Gear Fusion on laptop or computer. We browse lower a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we reach the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will load to enjoy the game Artery Gear Fusion on the PC. As you can discover from here, we have several pros of using the emulator. Then, we are ready to proceed to download the Artery Gear Fusion by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is. Here is located the download. It is a file to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the installer, okay, then we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the computer. We clicked yes. I reduce the internet browser to see the installer considerably better. The installation software is pretty simple. It consists of two possibilities, install, and setup path. I will clarify what setup path really does. We simply click on it. Therefore we note that we have here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we need to change this folder we have got to click on that, browse, button. Therefore we opt for another directory and install the emulator precisely where we prefer. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. I simply click on back. And therefore I just click install. Great. The setup starts and it's going to progress in the download of these megabytes that happens to be represented on our screen. The time you download it, it may be more or less MB. The download rate could go faster or at a lower speed, based on your internet and according to the performance of the emulator servers. Now they're going super fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator happens to be launched immediately. As you will notice, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will fill up and once it actually reaches the end, the emulator is started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has been launched, here for the very first time. Before we continue on, as you will notice, it has created two app icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the only one we're considering. The moment we need to run Artery Gear Fusion on our laptop or computer, we twice click this particular software icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should conduct the next step, that is a must-have, and this is to enter the Google Play Store. And we are going to just click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is started. Here we must log on. At present once we are there, we must definitely execute the next step that is definitely imperative. Therefore simply click on, sign in. At this point it shows, checking info. It can in some cases get stopped at, checking info, that's why it doesn't move ahead. In that case, you may try to log in after a number of hours it's going to most certainly be repaired. At this point we're going to enter our email and password. The email address has to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you may use the same exact email you are using right now in your own YouTube account. so that I will provide my info and I will come back after I have completed it. That's all, info entered. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We will say yes to them all by just hitting, I agree. After that, it makes us possible to back up to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected and it'll produce a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is started by default and immediately. To set up the application, we have to go to the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking on the icon indicated green colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of the Android emulator, we can see that we find here the install video game option. We then click on this button. At this point we have got the game. Let's quickly mouse click now on the install option that I'm presenting now in green color. This will commence the installation. At present it is going to install the game, it can take quite some time or perhaps it could possibly be almost immediate. It again all depends on our connection to the web. It's as of now completed setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking this button I'm emphasizing in green, to be able to launch Artery Gear Fusion for the very first time. I am now on the emulator desktop, and we are on the way to just click this new Artery Gear Fusion software icon that was provided. That game app is launched for the first time on your device. So there we end up with it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the volume of this emulator. This is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is actually the first one, we mouse click on that app icon that I'm designating in green color. Then the monitor is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Supposing that we would like to appreciate the video game using all the screen, we hit this app icon. And therefore we would likely already be experiencing the Android game in 100% screen mode. To leave the complete screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And therefore we would certainly already end up being in standard display screen mode. From now, I am choosing to reveal you the computer keyboard mapping and that is certainly extremely appealing. That strategy we definitely will be capable to play the game application more easily. The first point is to mouse click this computer keyboard icon. It's now time to make the required controls. I'll go ahead and keep the default settings, though if you plan to modify this, you may very well do it without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, such as, in Japanese. So to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. So there within additional controls, we just click that language drop down. We can also decide on the language we need, Italian, Mandarin, etc. As soon as the language is determined, we would save, the emulator would reboot, and also the game app, the next time we start it, would also be in the picked language. At this time, you can find another detail that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email telling you that a completely new electronic device has been linked to this Google account. It will definitely ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that electronic device. Of course, we ought not get worried, because the emulator is acting as an Android device. And then to find which device is being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we browse here to the model option, and right here we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for the training. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, particularly that you thought it was informative. If that is so, offer it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and if you have feedback, issues or ideas, let them in the comment field below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every once in a while, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of these video tutorials that happens to be showing up on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the upcoming training videos. Bye.